Hi, this is Anne-Marie Concepcion from InDesignSecrets.com. Have you ever been working on an InDesign layout and you're editing items, but some items just can't be selected? Here I'm trying to select these items in the header. And if I go to the object menu, there's nothing locked here. What's the problem? Well, those items are most likely on the master page. I'm going to show you in this video how to tell if something's on the master page and how to edit those items on the master or on the document page. If you're coming from a program that doesn't use master pages in quite the same way that InDesign does, or maybe doesn't use master pages at all, this can really throw you for a loop. But by the end of this tip, you'll be a pro. I'm going to switch to normal editing view by tapping on the W key so we can take a look at these frames here. I'm going to zoom in a bit with Command or Control Plus. And the frames around these items are dotted, whereas all the other frames are solid. That's a clue to you that this item is sitting on the master page. If you open up the Pages panel, you can see that there is a master page, and there's only two pages in this document. All InDesign files come with a master page. Some people just ignore them completely. But if you have any items that are repeated on your pages, like in this document, all the items on top get repeated and the Call Now button gets repeated on the bottom, then that makes sense to put it on the master page. But let's say that on this document, I want to change the color of the Call Now fill to match this orange scheme, just like this one is blue, to match that one. So I'm going to zoom in here. Again, I'm selecting something nearby to center it on the screen. And it is not selectable. If I go to the Pages panel, I can confirm that that item is way down there on the master page. There's the full master page. I'm going to come back here and zoom in again. The answer is to edit an item that comes from a master page on a document page, you hold down a couple keys when you click on it. That releases it from bondage. Hold down the Command and Shift key on a Mac or the Control and Shift key on Windows and click on the item. There you go. Now you can delete it. You can move it. Here I'm just going to select the type and make sure that my fill icon is selected. I want to fill it with a different color. That one looks pretty good. Oh, it looks like I have my show overrides turned on. There we go. And there you have it. Now, if you ever mess up, if you ever like completely mess up the master page item and you want to start over again, or maybe you accidentally deleted it, here's another great tip. Select that overridden master page item, go to the Pages panel menu, this little guy right here, go down to the master pages flyout. Now in earlier versions of InDesign, you might have to do a little hunting. They've been rearranging items here, but what you want to choose is remove selected local overrides. That means bring me back home to the master page, mama. There you go. And you can start all over again if you'd like. So that's how you edit master page items in an InDesign document. I sure hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.